Hey folks, got a short video today about a coffee maker. And it's not good. It's not good news. This Mr. Coffee, it's about 2 years old, belongs to my parents, and they said that it stopped heating. So normally, first thing you'd check would be the thermal fuses. So, and I've already taken this apart. I hadn't planned to make a video till the findings got interesting. Here in the bottom, these two parts underneath here, thermal fuses, if this element assembly starts to get too hot before it could damage this plastic or start a fire, those are one-shot fuses. They'll open and stop the current. That's what I expected to find wrong, but those are still good. So then I continued checking. Get this meter out here. I don't know if you'll be able to see it or not. On the screen there. I connect here. Good thermal fuse. Second one good. Thermostat good. So then I check the heating element. It's basically open. I'm getting 500 kilo. So that heating element should be somewhere in the 10-15 ohms range. So heating element's bad. That tells me that I probably won't be able to repair this. But then I just made an interesting discovery. If you look at this clamp that holds the system together, I don't know if it's going to show up on the video, but right there is an earth point emblem. And there's a screw hole. It's never had a screw in it, never had threads cut in it. So this plate here, this whole assembly, is definitely not grounded or earthed in any way. So for the most part, for it to be like that, it would have to be double insulated, where if any of the electrical parts short out and become electrically charged, that no external part of the machine out here is going to be electrically charged. But this plate, that's the bottom of the warmer plate where the coffee pot sits. Doesn't look like it's double insulated. And then I just, out of curiosity, I took the meter, I touched it to the warmer plate, and then to this side of the heating element, and look at that, 23 ohms. That's a massive short to earth right there. And if I take the whole unit and flip it over, I've got to get this where you can see it. And I've got the cord here. I'm going to take the meter, stick it in there. If I touch this to that warmer plate, ohms, that would be a horrible shock. There's 24 ohms right there. That could be a fatal shock. And that is something you use in the kitchen, near the sink and near water. Faulted from the cord directly to the warmer plate, through the heating element with a 25-26 ohm short. Now that right there is absolutely unacceptable. It even had a place for an earth connection onto the heating element, but they used this cheap two-wire cord instead of what they should have used. Now the real bad thing is, this same type of coffee pot, I've seen them with a stainless steel pitcher that fits in there, metal. So if that metal pitcher sits on that plate, you put the metal pitcher in there, that whole pitcher is going to be hot. And yeah, I know this is a heating plate and you get burned if you touch it, but that doesn't matter. Right now, with it off, it's connected to the line cord. And people can put a metal pitcher in there, and there you've got a serious shock hazard. Unacceptable design. Okay, now I'm going to do a voltage leakage test. Get this where you can see it. I'm going to plug in the coffee pot. Not even going to turn it on, just going to plug it in. I'm going to take the negative or black meter lead. I'm going to put it on ground, earth ground over here. Then I'm going to take the red and I'm going to touch it on the warmer. There's 122.7 volts right there touching that. And the coffee pot's not even on. So yeah, that's getting bad. Now I'll do a real test. I'm gonna go get something that'll carry some current and connect it and see how many amps of current it can deliver from that warmer plate. Okay, one last test before I put this thing to rest. Just because, like I said, I'm shocked, no pun intended, about the poor design and the safety issue it has. That meter is set on AC voltage scale, reading millivolts now. This metal tray is grounded. This would simulate your stovetop or kitchen sink or anything metal in the kitchen. Touch this here, touch it on there. Scratch through the rust, 117 volts. Now, maybe it would just give a tingle if you touched it, but I don't think so. I think it would give a horrible shock. So what we got here, the light bulb, 120 volt, 15 watt. And I'm just going to clip it in a test lead like that. I'm going to connect this part of the lead to the grounded tabletop to simulate the kitchen sink or the stovetop. And then I'm going to carefully touch this in here. Look at that. I'm picking up enough power to light up that light bulb full brightness. And the coffee pot's not even on. So if you got this type of coffee maker with a two-wire cord, you might want to check into it. I don't know how safe it is. Now, most homes have got GFCI or RCD protection for the kitchen outlets, but not all do. And once again, that won't keep you from getting shocked. It will turn off the current after you've begun to get shocked. It's still not a completely safe situation. And there's a lot of times people set a coffee maker up, not in the kitchen, they set it up somewhere else where there might not be a GFCI. In that case, this one would be very, very dangerous. So I hope y'all got something out of this video, and maybe it saves you from getting shocked. That's it for now.